Have you ever had to make changes to your construction drawings after they've been produced? Maybe you had to change a side slope within a set of cross sections. And in doing that, you change the graphics of that cross section rather than changing the digital data or the terrain model that had been created previously. Wouldn't it be nice if we could change the model and the plans update automatically? With OpenRoads Designer and a model-centric plan production methodology, you can be sure that the plans reflect the model and the model reflects the plans, because we've made editing and changing the model much simpler than in the past. Take just a few minutes and let's take a look. Here, in highlighting a model-centric plan production methodology, I'm actually laying out my cross sections along my roadway corridor. We call them named boundaries, and you actually can see them displayed within the three-dimensional model. So we're actually creating live views or windows at specific stations along our roadway corridor, which will be the views in the cross-section sheets. So here I've opened up the named boundary manager. You can see each of those named boundaries present. I have the ability to modify the display of those boundaries, turn them on or turn them off, and then from here I can actually create the cross-section drawings. So I'm going to create the drawings, and as it processes, again, it's taking each of these views or these windows into the design model and placing them onto sheets. Now I see those sheets represented, and I can move from each drawing to each drawing. Now what happens when modifications to our design model need to be implemented? So here I've opened up one of the cross-section sheets. You can see it in the lower left. And now we're going to modify the roadway corridor or the design model itself. We're going to steepen the four slope into this special ditch. I'm going to change that to a 2-to-1 slope, again, to manage that side slope as it relates to the right-of-way line. Notice the model, the dynamic section, and the cross-section sheet all update. So as the model changes, we see those changes propagated throughout our design, including the plan production sheets, which we see here on the screen. In addition to changes within the model itself, what happens with annotation elements? Here we've got a plan and profile sheet, and we have a special ditch profile defined in the profile view. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to place some annotation, place the station and elevation along several points of that profile within my plan and profile sheet. So I'll go out, I'll select the station and elevation symbology or style that I want to use, I'll place that on that profile element within the drawing. So we'll just place that, take a look at it now within the plan and profile sheet itself. We see the annotation along that profile element, which represents, again, the flow line of a special ditch. We move from the drawing back to the design model. And now what happens when the design model changes, when that profile changes within my design model? So let's take a look. I've opened up the plan and profile itself, zoomed into the area that we're looking at, and now I'm going to make a modification to the flow line of that ditch. Notice as I make that modification within the design model, what happens to the annotation and the element within the plan and profile sheet. So text annotation is associative and dynamic. So as the model updates, the drawings and the annotation update as well. Thanks for taking some time out of your busy schedule to join me as we looked at a model-centric approach inside of OpenRoads Designer. Hopefully you discovered how modeling and plan production out of a model-centric approach means that you can model, you can make changes to that model while ensuring that your plans are up to date and meet exactly what you've designed within that design model. If you'd like more information on OpenRoads Designer, look us up at bentley.com or use the link included in this video.